play this little free game we just got from the PlayStation Store. PSN members, well, not PSN members, but PlayStation Plus members get this game for free this month. I've played it a little bit. It's actually quite interesting. It's got a nice little story to it. If you really like survival games, you're going to like this. I've learned a little bit, but I'm going to try to do a walkthrough here, show you guys how to play, just in case you're wondering, just to give you a little bit of advice, maybe. I've learned a few things. I'm going to keep repeating myself. I don't know why, but let's get right into it. I'm not going to continue. I'm actually just going to start over, show you guys everything. Let's see if I've still got my characters I created. Why would they be at the lot? Yeah, okay. They're in the end. A lot of friends, a lot of family members. That's one cool thing about this game is you can make it really personal if you like. Got all my best friends and a lot of my family members on here. We're going to roll with Gamer Junkie himself, Craig, Adam. Whoop, I'm pushing wrong buttons here. Okay, there we go, and myself. The faces aren't exactly, they don't show what my friends would actually look like. They're the kind of default portraits, but we'll just roll with it. Let's make this a long one, huh? I believe 80 is the max. Okay, we're going to leave the difficulty on moderate. We're going to put everything to sort of a moderate level. Okay, halfway. We'll open up the whole map. To some, this game may seem boring. I'm sorry if that's the case. But this is a very slow game, a lot of reading, a lot of just waiting. I don't exactly know what to call that kind of game, but there's a lot of waiting and just a lot of strategy involved in this game. You make wrong decisions, it could cost you a lot in this game, so you just got to take your time and make the right decisions. Let's see. I see at the left side of the screen, when you go to a certain area of the map, you see, for example, here, supermarket, soldiers and scavengers. How do I change that? The store supply. Supermarket is located. I don't exactly know what that is, so we're just going to leave it at the default, whatever they've got set. Oh, look at that. I've already got it saved, actually. We'll roll with the save map. Let's go ahead and get it started. That seems the same as the first time I played. Okay. Three dozens, we're lucky. So things are in bad shape right now in this city. There's war raging. There's not a whole lot of stuff to scavenge. Not many supplies. Not many people alive. People just trying to make it, man. Let's go with it. First thing we want to do, let's go ahead and search the house here. We're gonna run with old Gamer Junkie here. See what he can find. Okay, we got herbs, parts, sugar, and electric parts. All good stuff to have, all very common. But we need these things. Oh, we got some water, that's a plus. Sugar, so far, mostly has just been good for trading. Herbs, the same. Let's go down. At least it's warm. Yeah, it started off, looks like it's going to be pretty warm for a little while. I don't know how close winter is. I haven't dealt with winter yet, but I imagine that's a pretty serious time. You need probably to keep the heat up and maybe even more food and more water. Not sure we'll find that out on our adventure here together, huh? Okay, we got a barricade on this door. Let's break it down, see what we can find in here. More of the same. Good deal. All right, we got a large pile of rubble here. This will take Joe a little while to move without a shovel, but we'll get a shovel later and work on moving things a bit quicker. We'll go with Adam, my nephew here, and we'll get him searching around, find some stuff. Now he's going to go ahead and get started on this pile of rubble. On to Craig. Looks like he'll be moving this pile of rubble over here. Oh, never mind, that door's locked. We need a lockpick or a crowbar or something to open that door. I guess we'll go upstairs. Wait a minute. We may have what we need to make a crowbar. That would be a nice thing to have right now. Oh, okay. We got to make a workbench, I think. Yeah. We got the stuff to make a workbench. Let's go ahead and do that. We'll just put it right here with the other workbench. Okay. See if there's anything outside useful. I don't think there is. Head on upstairs, see what we can find. And, oh, look at there, there's a lockpick. We found some food, very good. Lots of components, lots of wood. That's a good find there. Let's keep looking. Looks like Joe's still down there and Adam's still moving those piles of rubble. More water, more herbs, okay. Go ahead and move this barricade. Okay, Craig's done with the workbench. Let's see if we can get a crowbar. Absolutely. Joe's done down here. Need a lockpick. We do have a lockpick, but I think I'm going to save that for trading. When that crowbar is done, we can open that cabinet pretty easily. Adam's almost done. Let's see what he... another pile of rubble. We're going to keep Adam... We're going to put him to work, huh? He's going to move another pile of rubble for us. Crowbar is done. Let's go ahead and open this door. Let's see. Nothing in the bathroom here. I didn't mean to shut that door, but... Okay. Let's head on upstairs. Looks like we're going to have a couple piles of rubble up here to move. Maybe we should go ahead and try to make a shovel, too. We'll get to it eventually. Got this door open. Alright. Move this pile of rubble. Open this cabinet. Maybe we'll find something good in here. Man, if we could find a gun right off the bat, that'd be great. Oh yeah, got some medicine. Another lockpick. Very good. Everybody's busy, but yeah, let's take him on upstairs. Hmm. one thing we're definitely gonna need is some beds. Let's go ahead and get some beds built. People can get some rest when we need. Let's just make sure there's nothing else more important right now. We also need a stove as quickly as possible. And water collector, rainwater collector. Beds are more important right now though. Let's go ahead and put the beds. We may be able to fit a few beds down here. Yeah. Let's put a bed right here. Yeah. I'm gonna open this up. Okay, also each survivor has their own, how do I put it? They have their own abilities. They're really good at certain things and not so good at others. Adam is an insurance agent, I believe, so he's really persuasive. So he's the guy you'd want to pick to do trading and to bartering and maybe even maybe if people get, you know, a little stressed out, he can calm them down, things like that. The game's really interesting in that aspect. Okay, let me open this up, see what we got here. More goodies. That's one bed down. Let's go ahead and make some more beds. Joe is more of a computer specialist. He's really good at anything electronic. He's really good at building most anything, I would say. Radios, like a radio here, maybe even the heater, the workbenches. He'd be the guy to pick to do those kinds of things. He's very handy. Just keep the beds going. I say we build four beds at least. Get four beds in here at some point. I don't know about right off the get-go, but. Okay, already Craig is slightly sick. We may want to go ahead and take care of that before it gets out of hand. We had a bottle of meds. Do we want to use them that quick though? Maybe a little rest will help him. Maybe he'll come out of it if he gets a little rest. Craig, he's really good with medicines. So when you go to make medicines or bandages, healing people, he's the guy to go to. I'm more of the defensive guy, or maybe even offense as well, going out and scavenging. I may be the one to go with for that kind of stuff. Alright, the first night. Okay. I'm gonna go out and scavenge. We want Joe on guard. Craig in the bed. He's sick. We're gonna put Adam on guard too. Alright, where are we gonna go? Abandoned cottage or shelled cottage? Okay, the abandoned cottage. A family barricaded themselves in this house, but despite their efforts, looters got inside. It's been abandoned ever since. Still, we might find useful things that the looters overlooked. We don't want to rob anybody. Let's go to the shell college. This neighborhood recently got shelled, and many houses are still burning. People were fleeing for their lives in a hurry, so we may find some useful stuff there. Got food, materials, meds, weapons, and parts. Let's go check it out. We want to take a crowbar with us. I think we'll be good to go with that. Our first scavenge. The little red pulses on the screen there represent movement. Looks like it was just a rat. That doesn't mean there aren't any bandits or anyone living here though. Lots of components and wood. A broken toy. We'll just take the wood and the components for now. The toy doesn't seem very important right now. Oh yeah, lots of wooden components. Let's take it. Need some wood here. Alright, we're full right now. Our inventory is full, but let's not waste this trip. Let's go ahead and check the house, see what's in it. We'll come back for the other stuff later. We got some movement upstairs. Might want to be careful there. Ooh, lots of food. And water. Wow. Okay. I think we should take all the food and water. We don't want to leave that. It may not be here when we come back. That's something you don't want to pass up. Okay, we're full once again. Let's see what else we can find. There may be something more important here. Food, meds, and weapons are definitely things you don't want to pass up. I'm not sure if the stuff that we don't take will be here when we come back. We'll find that out as we play. But just in case it's not going to be there when we come back, we'll go ahead and take the most important stuff right now. We got movement upstairs. We might want to be careful there. Oh, bandages. Yep, don't want to pass that up. Let's put some components back because we can't carry a whole lot of wood. We got that movement upstairs, so let's go downstairs. Daylight on this game, I think, is about 5 o'clock. You definitely want to get back home before 5, so we're going to leave about 4 o'clock. Maybe even 4:30. Make sure we're out here about 4:30 just to be safe. Lots of wood. There's a lot of stuff here to come back for. Let's go ahead and move this pile of rubble while we're here. This is the part of the game that people may find a little boring. Some things take quite a while to get done. Looks like there's also a pile of rubble over at that other door. We may want to move it before we leave. Check upstairs, see what's going on. I got a feeling that's just a rat upstairs. We may be wrong though, so. Gotta stay aware. Here's my biography. Just before war reach. Okay, so it appears my house burned down right as everything hit the fan. Went back to find my wife. Didn't find her or her body, so she may be out there somewhere. It appears looking at the bios, pause, whatever's going on, so that may come in handy at some point. Okay, here we go. Might be something important in here. Cross your fingers, guys. Make a lot of noise doing this, but... Oh, whatever that was is coming downstairs. Let's put that one water back. Take the bandage. Ooh, ammo. We'll come back for the ammo. Hopefully it's still here. Whatever's upstairs started to come down, but now it's went back upstairs. Try to sneak up there and see what it is. Okay, it's got to be a rat, yeah. Lots of wooden components. Man, we got to come back here tomorrow night. Bring home a lot more stuff. Dropped on the city. It reads, this is a war zone. This is a zone of anti-terrorist operation. Persons remaining in the city. Leave immediately. The army guarantees you a safe passage. Not many believed them after the atrocities they committed. Okay, so the army doesn't have a great reputation, it appears. We maybe need to watch out for them, huh? Lots of wood, lots of components. And, oh, weapon parts, that's nice. We're gonna leave with what we've got, though. It appears we've searched everything. Let's get out of here. Come back tomorrow night and get a whole bunch of this nice stuff. Right on. Day two. Through our first day very successfully, I believe. Only problem we're having right now is Craig's a little sick. Let's hope he feels better now. Okay, Craig now is hungry and slightly sick but recovering. That's a plus, huh? Everybody's hungry and tired. Okay. We're gonna let Craig rest. What to do? Let's go ahead and get some more beds built. We're gonna put Adam back to work up here, clearing this pile of rubble over here. I'm gonna go get some rest. Be ready for tonight. Joe, build us another bed, brother. Okay, we got three beds built downstairs now. That, I believe, will be sufficient. We'll save what materials we got for other more important things. Go ahead and clear this pile of rubble. We need to get a rainwater collector built. Maybe a stove. Yeah, we definitely need to get the stove built. Welcome to the stream, man. We just got started on this game. It's a free PSN game, This War of Mine. I'm not sure if you know anything about it. So far, it's really fun, though. Appreciate you watching. We're on day two. We just got started. You haven't missed much. Okay, we don't have the materials to build our stove or rainwater collector yet. We don't really need a radio yet either, so let's save our materials. What to do now? Let's go see if there's any more work to be done around this house. Nothing in the bathroom. Leads outside. Nothing in here. We've almost searched the entire building, I believe. We'll leave that, the upstairs stuff here to Adam to take care of. Oh, just to put it out there, all of our characters we're playing with here are members of Budo Gaming, so eventually you're going to hear from all of them. You're going to see videos from them. We'll be collabing on a lot of stuff. Playing some GTA together and some Call of Duty and some Battlefield. We got a lot of really great material coming for you guys. Just stay tuned. Be patient. We're all eventually going to reveal our faces and you're going to see us on live cam. We're working on all that right now. Just a matter of time. Let's go back to Adam. Okay, he's got another barricade here to move. Nothing to it. Alright, let's see what we get in here. Should be something good. yeah, some bandages and some more food. Herbs are always nice too. We're stocking up on the herbs. We'll use those for trading most likely because we've got some medicine. Bandages and medicine and food and weapons, things like that are very high value trade items. Jewelry. Most of this other stuff is just kind of common though, so it's not the greatest trade items. But medicine, food, and weapons are very valuable trade items. Looks like I got all the rest I needed. Let's let Joe get some rest, huh? We still got a little time in the day. And Adam needs to rest. Up the ladder to go down. We need food. We've got food. You're gonna get to eat, old buddy. Alright. Now, we found some more materials, I believe. Let's see what else we can build. We really need to get the rainwater collector built. Not quite enough yet, though. We need wood badly. So, tonight when we go scavenging, we're going to come back with a lot of components and a lot of wood. You can also upgrade your workbenches and your crafting stations. I kind of wanted to make a shovel too. We're missing the wood. There's weapon parts at that house we're going to scavenge for as well. We may want to come back with those. Okay. Now we're just gonna kill a little bit of time and wait for the sun to go down, wait for the sun to set, and go out and scavenge and get that stuff we need. Let's check out some bios while we're waiting. Okay, so Joe tried to flee the city. He seemed like a pretty normal guy. He tried to flee the city and got caught in all the combat and all the things going on. Let's see. Adam's got a girlfriend named Kate. Met during a student exchange in the United Kingdom. They lived together. They were about to get married, but everything hit the fan. She got away, but he didn't. It's been about 3 years, and he's worried about her safety. Let's see. Craig got promoted. Well, it says that Craig hit out with his family, but it doesn't say what happened to his family. We managed to hide in our basement just before the first explosion shook the ground and everything got covered by dust. It doesn't say what happened to his family, though. That's odd. But he's with family, so everything's okay right now. Maybe his family will turn up. Hadn't played a whole lot of this game. I may have put in a couple hours just to see how the game worked, to get a good feel for it. But I haven't seen much happen. I think I got to day 9, maybe 8 or 9. But we'll be going out on a scavenging run here very soon. The scavenging runs, I believe, start at 8. I can skip all this time, but that's just another thing I'm not sure of. Does skipping all this time cause all of the rest that you could have gotten to be skipped and not count. I'm not sure yet. We'll figure it out, though. Alright, what do we want to do here? I'm gonna scavenge. Joe's gonna guard. Adam's gonna rest. And Craig's gonna rest. Okay. This looks good. Let's go back to that shield cottage. Take a crowbar. We need to come back with a lot of components and wood. Maybe even those weapon parts. I can't remember if there was much else more important than that. This is just a toy, I think. Lots of components, let's take those. Okay, I don't know if maybe things have changed. There may be someone here now, so let's be vigilant. We'll leave the herb and the sugar. Let's take all this wood. I don't see any movement around the house. We'll leave the herbs and the sugar. Components. I don't want the toy. Haven't figured out really what toys are good for yet. Oh, there's movement upstairs. Let's take this wood. See what's going on here with this movement. Coming our way. Get our crowbar out. They've stopped. Going upstairs? No. We really don't want to run into anyone right now. We couldn't defend ourselves if they've got a firearm. Got a feeling it may be just a rat. Let's take the risk. Yep, okay, just a rat. Let's go back downstairs, see what we can find. Pushed up on the directional pad to go back to scavenge mode, and it sent me back up the stairs. Still getting used to the movement of this game, too. Can't say it's the most smooth. Some water, some shell casings, some gunpowder. I don't think we need any of that. What do we got? Lots of components and lots of wood. This is really everything we needed, but let's look upstairs just in case, see if there was something more important. Haven't got the greatest memory in the world, guys. I don't remember what and all was here. More wooden components. More wooden components. And the weapon parts and these parts. Electric parts. I kind of feel like we needed those. What was it we needed weapon parts for? A knife, I think it was, wasn't it? Defense is very important. But if I remember correctly, we needed three. So let's wait till we've got a weapon part or two. We'll come back and get these parts. The electric parts for maybe the stove. I think we're good. Let's head on back. See, now we're leaving with a lot of time to spare. I don't know if that is a plus or if it doesn't matter at all. I'm not sure. Maybe if you use that time, you'd get more hungry, more tired. Not sure of these things yet. Day three. Let's hope Craig feels better. We've got some medicine that if he gets worse, we'll use, but that'd be great to save. Okay. Good, Craig got better. That's awesome. Okay, I'm gonna go on down and rest. Who else is tired? Joe is on guard. Let's let him rest. Adam's in good shape. Craig's in good shape. So let's use them to do the work that needs to be done. What do we need now? A stove would be great, and the water collection would be great. Okay, we're looking good. We got plenty of water right now, so let's go ahead and get our stove built. Where do we want to put it? We got room for one more bed. Let's put it... We'll use this room here for, like, the kitchen. We don't want to put it all the way up here. This is obviously the kitchen, but... The less running around we get, we can do, the better. Let's go ahead and put it, like, right here. I don't know, there's something about this I don't really want to put it there. Something's telling me not to. Maybe down here? Ah, screw it. Let's put it in the kitchen. Let's put things where they're supposed to go, yeah. Alright, Adam. Make us a water purifier. How about that? Water collector. Where are we gonna put it? Got lots of room. If we could put it in the kitchen, that'd be great. Be right there with the stove. That's not gonna happen though. It's got like a little pipe sticking out the top of it, yeah. So let's stick that pipe out the window, huh? Let's put the water purifier right here. Keep a little bit of realism in as much as we can. But man, I don't wanna put it all the way up there. Let's cancel that. Let's put it somewhere else. We're gonna try and keep things as convenient as possible right now. We got nothing but time. Oh, someone's at the door. Where is the door? Okay, looks like a traitor. This is where we're gonna wanna use Adam, because he's got the persuasive abilities, the insurance agent, the businessman. How's it going, buddy? Let's make a deal. Alright, let's deal. What do we need? Okay, it shows our inventory on the left and his on the right. Something to defend ourselves will be great, because we've got food, we've got water, we've got meds, we've got lots of supplies. We could use some wood, looks like. He's got tobacco. He's got herbal medicine. Cigarettes. He's got some meat. Vegetables would have been nice. He doesn't have any weapons. He has some ammunition, but no weapons. Okay. Moonshine. Lots of wood. Alright, weapon parts. We may want to go ahead and take some of his weapon parts and get us some knives built. We don't need much else, really. Maybe some wood. Let's take his weapon parts. We'll take these parts. And we've got lots of components, but let's take like 8 components. And all the wood we can get. Alright. What are we gonna trade him? We've got some jewelry. Jewelry is pretty useless other than trading, as far as I know. Let's see if we can give him these herbs. How many you want, man? Okay. Took a lot of them, but... We've got medicine, so we don't really need these herbs, in my opinion. Okay, so some components, some parts, weapon parts, and wood. We've got lots of components, so let's go for some more of his wood. Let's put these parts back, take some more wood. very generous of you. Okay, so we're making a great offer right now. Maybe we can take some of those herbs back. Okay, we can take two or three herbs back. Looks like a good deal to me. Okay, let's see what else we can do. What else do we want from him? We've got three herbs. The lockpicks. Is he interested in lockpicks? Not nothing special, but not bad either. Okay, let's try to get this bandage off of him. We'll give you the lockpicks. You want some sugar? I may regret this later, but I'm not sure what sugar's for other than, like, for, fermenting, like, moonshine and things. We'll give him a bunch of sugar. We'll get that bandage off of him. Got a lot of cigarettes. Quality roll-up and roll-up cigarette. Okay. One's just a roll-up and one is already rolled up. Yeah, let's go with that. Looks like a good deal to me. Bandages are super important. In just the 6 or 7 days that I played the game, maybe 8, I used quite a few bandages. Because eventually we're going to start getting raided. Bandits are going to start attacking us. People get hurt. We need to get some knives made. Okay, let's see. What else? We got those herbs we don't really want. And more sugar. Got lots of water, and we're getting ready to have some more water coming in. We also have these books and jewelry that we're not going to use for anything but trade. Yeah, let's try to get something else off of him. Some more wood. See if we can get all this wood from him. Let's give him the sugar, the herbs. What else? Let's see how the books do. Okay, the books didn't quite do it. I know the jewelry is going to do it. Yeah, very generous of you. Let's go ahead and see what we see here. We don't want sugar. We probably could use all those components. Will you give up the herbal meds? No, it won't do. Try harder. No. Okay, we don't want the herbal meds. We don't really need them. Still giving him a very generous offer. Will you give up some food? Yeah, okay, he'll give us some food. Fine, we can have a deal. So maybe we can get something else out of him. I doubt we can get another piece of meat. No. Do we have anything else? No. Take back some meat. He says we can have a deal right now. I'm just seeing if I can get anything else out of him. Quite common, being honest. Moonshine would cost us. How about these parts? Won't do. Okay, let's just go ahead and make a deal. I think we're good. We don't have much we want to trade right now anyway. We're good on what we've got. Appreciate you, buddy. Have a good one. Hope the snipers won't see me. Yep. Good luck, buddy. Keep your head down. Okay. Let's go ahead and get to crafting some stuff. We got plenty of bandages. We got medicine, food, and water. We're doing really great. My first little bit of playing this game didn't go nearly as well as it's going right now. What do we want? Did we build the stove? Okay, we got the stove. Did we do the water purifier? Yep, it's somewhere. Where did we put it? No. Actually, I canceled that, didn't I? All right, let's build us a water purifier. Or water collector. Let's put it... Okay, this just doesn't look realistic, so... Yeah, let's put it there. It's sticking through the wall outside, yeah. Catching water outside. Let's get Adam to do something here. Where's the crafting bench? I'm going the wrong way. Anything at the... What was this called? One's a workbench and the other is a workshop. Okay. See what we got on the workbench. Anything? Oh, we needed the knives. That's right. Even a shovel, maybe. We can make one knife. That'd take up a lot. That'd pretty much leave us without any components. But we do need something to defend ourselves a little bit, at least, with. That rainwater collector cost us a lot of components. Alright, Joe and I are arrested. Everybody's looking good. We're all just a little hungry. We'll wait till we're very hungry before we start eating food. It's almost 2 p.m. Let's just wait a little while. Oh, let's get some rainwater. What do we need? We need a... I think that's like a filter. Who's near the workbench? Okay. What does it take to make a filter? Yeah, filter. Okay. Ooh, we can just barely make it. Let's go ahead and make one and get some rainwater. Alright, that's done. Let's stick the filter in there, Craig. Our viewers left us, man. It's all good, though. This game is, it may seem boring to some people. I just figured I'd give it a shot, see how you guys liked it. If you are enjoying watching me play this, leave a like, comment. Please subscribe, help me out. If you leave plenty of likes, we'll keep this going. We'll make it a series. We'll pull the whole 80 days, see how well we can do. Let's go ahead and, can we make one more bed? No, we're all out of supplies, guys. All out of wood and components. Well, we got wood, but we're out of components. We traded for a whole lot of components there. We used them on the rainwater collector. So you go ahead and make some food and have it ready. It sounded like somebody's knocking. Where's the front door? There's nobody at the door. Hey, what do we need? Fuel. Gotta have fuel. And that requires wood. Okay, let's make some fuel. Go ahead and prepare some food. Have it ready for tomorrow, because I say we're all going to be pretty hungry tomorrow. Okay, cooked food. One or two. We'll go ahead and make two. Took our only vegetable, so. But we'll have two nice plates of food ready to go. Almost time to go scavenging. We're gonna go back to the same house and I guess bring back some more components and wood, because there's plenty still there. Now we wait. You know what? Let's go ahead and end it. Get on to the scavenging. Are you sure you want to end the day? I'm not sure what the repercussions are for that or if there are any benefits, but let's go with it. If anyone that's watching this knows, please comment down below. Let me know what the downsides or the ups are of skipping over some time. Because you can skip time during your stuff you're doing at your home, and you can also skip time when you're out scavenging. Okay, I'm gonna scavenge. Add them on guard. Let's just put everybody on guard. Well, wait, let's think about it. Well, that'll mean tomorrow we'll all be tired. So, let's let Craig sleep. That way he can be up doing things tomorrow and us three can get rest. Okay. Back to the shelled cottage. Yep. We don't need a crowbar anymore. Let's do it. That was just a toy. It appears things kind of just stay the same on each level. I don't see any movement. I see that rat there. That's a fat rat boy. Alright, let's not take any of that. Let's get all the wooden components we can. Nope. Go down in the basement, see what we got. I know there was a lot of wooden components upstairs. There's some wood. Water and stuff. Real tobacco, cigarette, often used as currency in times of war. It may come in handy at some point. We'll just have to remember it's here. We don't need any of this stuff. We need wooden components. Go ahead and move this. There may be something outside there important. Like a pile of stuff sitting outside. We'll build a shovel as soon as possible. That way we can come back to certain areas with the shovel and move some of this stuff a lot quicker. We've got a crowbar that's, I think, about at half durability. It should last a little longer. Come on! Almost there. There'll be something good out there. It's probably exactly what we need, components and wood. Oh, okay. Some parts, some weapon parts, electrical parts. We don't need any of this right now. Fertilizer, that'll come in handy at some point. We know this stuff is here. We'll come back for it. What's in the bed? Under the bed. Teddy bear, no thank you. Got some movement in that room there. I'm sure it's just a rat though. We can look. Yep, just a rat. Take all of that. Let's see, we got lots of components. Let's take the wood. We should be good to go now. Weapon parts and stuff there. We'll come back for that as well. Still lots of wood and components here. Day 4. So far, so good. I found plenty of really fine stuff. What a night. Yeah, man. Alright. Let's put me in the bed. I'm very hungry. Actually, let's go eat before we lay down. Yeah, I'm climbing that ladder a little slow. Joe needs some rest. He's hungry. Let's go ahead and feed him and we'll get him some rest. Okay, we were very hungry. Now we're just hungry. So we may actually start feeding our guys when they're hungry. So they'll just be in a much better mood, I'd say. Let's go ahead and make some more food, get everybody fed. We've got 7 meat, But without vegetables, you can't make a whole lot of food with it. We're gonna scav. I believe we're gonna scavenge somewhere else on the next night. Try to come back with some vegetables or some canned food or something. So, well, Joe's sad. Don't know what to change that. Let's let him get some rest. Adam very hungry and Craig very hungry. Adam's tired too. Let's let Adam get some rest. Craig, go ahead and build us some stuff. Oh, someone's at the door. Who is that? Looks like two little kids. Our mom is sick. Please help. Uh-oh. We live several blocks away from here. Our mom is very ill. She needs medications. Could you please spare any without our help? Without your help, she will die. Had your daddy went to fight, we have. They want our medicines. Mom's very sick. None of us are sick. Let's go ahead and do it. I can't say no to the little youngins, man. Thank you. Quickly, let's get the medicine to Mom. Yeah, get back home. Fix her up. Adam, get some rest. Alright. Let's see what we can build. We still got bandages, so I just went the wrong way again. What can we build? Another bed would become in handy. Not really though, if you think about it, three beds is all you need because you're always going to want somebody up during the day doing things. So three beds will be sufficient. Maybe the radio, Joe's sad, maybe the radio will cheer him up. That might be nice to have. We don't need a heater. It's not hot, I mean not cold. Moonshine still. That might cheer some people up. Let's go ahead and do a radio. Let's put it down here with the beds and stuff. Or maybe put it in the workshop. Can't do that. In the kitchen, can't do that. Let's just put it right here. Or put it at the front door maybe. That way people come in, you know, lighten the mood a little bit. Radio playing. Yeah, we'll put it at the front door. And that's pretty much all we need to build right now. Maybe we can upgrade our workshop and workbench. See what's on the radio. The rebel leader instructed us to warn the listeners not to cross the front line. Failure to comply could result in death. City remains cut off. No aid. Okay, so they're thinking if they let aid in, people get aid, that it'll end up in rebel hands. Music's playing on that station. Classical music on that station. Actually, they should be warm and pleasant. Oh, okay, there's a forecast. Let's leave it on some music. Some classical it is. Alright. Let's go see about upgrading some stuff. What do we want to upgrade? Okay, we can't upgrade this yet. We don't have the components. But when we do, we'll be able... We'll have more options with food or meds and trade goods. Build more sophisticated items and appliances. Okay. Just need more components. Didn't mean to hit that. Okay, there we go. Now we need components to upgrade this. We can make an axe and a saw blade. We can fix broken firearms and helmets. We can upgrade it even further to make ammo and fix bulletproof vests. Nice. Okay. Keep that in mind. I believe that's about all we can do. Oh, let's go see what's going on with the water. Got our guys rested up down here. Alright, we need another filter. I don't remember what it takes to make a filter, but if it takes components, I say we hold off, because we've got 16 water. We're doing pretty good on water, I think. I gotta stay... Whoa. I gotta stay down here to make this. That takes components, but it only takes 3. Wait, this takes wood. Yep, let's make a... Nope, gotta have a filter. Can't have fuel. It'll take 3 of our components. We don't need water. And that's about all we can do, so let's skip the night. Alright. Adam's very hungry. He's gonna guard. Joe can guard. I'm gonna scavenge. And Craig can get some sleep, so he'll be up tomorrow. Alright, let's go somewhere new. We need vegetables and components. Ruined block of flats. This block of flats has seen some heavy fighting with people. The military. The battle's over. Lots of food, huge amounts of materials, meds, weapons, parts. Let's do it. Let's go there. Take our crowbar. So empty and quiet here, it gives me the creeps. We'll be alright. See what we got in here. A bone and some wood, we'll take it. Looks like there's no one here. Not showing any movement. Oh yeah, there's some food and some ammo. We'll just take all that for now until we find something better. Baby carriage is empty. A few objects lie scattered inside. A rattle, smiling red crab. Well worn by baby teeth. What's a crab? What's a red crab? Like a toy crab it was chewing on, I guess? A feeding bottle half full of congealed mass. Someone must have left in a terrible rush. Coffee. Fertilizer, cigarettes. Let's take this stuff for now. Take a peek. See what's in here. Looks clear. Lots of components and wood, we'll take it. Put 2 components and all the wood we can hold. Wait. I don't think we need any electric parts, and we don't need ammo because we don't have a gun right now, so let's take all the wood we can carry. What's in here? More fertilizer, weapon parts, nice. Nothing we need right now. Oh yeah, more meat, more wood, more components. Ooh, iron bars, huh? We need a saw blade for that, so we may want to build one of those ASAP. More wooden components. Let's put this part back and get some more wood. Okay. More iron bars. Okay. What do we got? Let's put one stack of wood back and get some more components. Because we were short on components. Maybe even two stacks of components, because that's what we're really low on. I feel like we were doing pretty well on wood. Yeah, I'm even going to put another stack of wood back and get some more components. Let's head home. We need a saw blade. No basement to this place? Okay. We're out of here. That went well. Lots of wood and components. We don't know what else is here. We know we need a saw blade before we come back. So we need to upgrade our workbench. Look what I got. Oh, we got raided. Let's see how bad it is. They stole lots of food and lots of water, man. That sucks. Nobody got hurt, though. That's good. That really sucks. I guess we... There might be some vegetables and some food, more food at the place we were at. Adam and Craig are very hungry. Everyone's tired except Craig. Let's all go get some rest. That sucks, man. We had a knife, but I guess it wasn't enough to fend off against the raiders. We need to try to upgrade the workbench and get a saw blade. Okay. Please let us be able to upgrade. Alright, let's go ahead and do that. Now we're sort of low on water. There was two sets of iron bars there, so we need two saw blades. We don't have what it takes to make a saw blade. That sucks. What else can there be done today? Well, we need water, so let's go. Let's make a filter, get some water coming in. Use up what components we've got left, pretty much. We don't come back with some vegetables from the next scavenger hunt, we'll just go ahead and make single plates of food. After this, I guess we'll just skip. I'm not seeing any downsides from skipping over days, so we'll just go ahead and do it when it needs to be done. And let's go on and start scavenging. Okay, yeah, so everything that would have been done otherwise if you hadn't skipped gets done when you do skip, so. I'm gonna scavenge. We'll put Joe on guard and Craig on guard and let Adam sleep. And we're gonna go elsewhere, because I don't remember there being anything else at the place we just visited that wasn't behind the bars. Supermarket. There's a place for food. This ore supplied the whole neighborhood before the latter turned into a war zone. It might be dangerous, but there may be groceries. Might be worth the risk. Let's do it. Take a crowbar. So we need to come back with components, if possible. And of course, food. Sure. Oh, hello. That's a pretty neighbor. That's a pretty face. What do we got going on here? There's two people. She seems to just be scavenging. That looks like a military guy. I don't see a gun or anything, though. I can give you food for a favor. Just come with me, babe. We'll dine and have some fun. This doesn't look like it's gonna go well. What can I do though? I got a crowbar. I guess I can hit the shit, hits the fan. Yeah, and it's hitting the fan too. Uh-oh. I'm gonna start out here to do what I say. Yeah, you need to go on home. Oh, yep, he's got a gun. What can we do here? I'm gonna go for it. I'm trying to change targets. Here we go. No. Oh, nice. Oh, that's not good. Get him, son. Oh, get him. Oh, God. Please don't kill me. Oh, come on. Hit him. Oh. Well, that's no good. Why couldn't I get another swing in on him? I hit him. I attacked him really well the first hit. But after that, he just kept hitting me. Well, that sucks. I'm out. Dallas was killed looking for supplies. That sucks. That really sucks. Lost our crowbar too, I guess. Damn. So we wasted a night there and lost one of our survivors. Joe's really hungry, depressed, and tired. Adam's starving and sad. Craig's starving, sad, and tired. Let's go ahead and eat. I don't like how that ended, man. I snuck up behind him with a crowbar and whacked him, and then I tried to hit him again, but he just wouldn't do it. Kept getting hit by, he kept hitting me with the butt of the gun. And we need fuel. So I'll go up here and eat. Some more fuel, I guess. We just made two fuel. Oh, it takes two fuel to get one plate of food. Yeah, making one plate of feud is what I was trying to say. One plate of food takes a lot of supplies to make. It's not really worth it. So you want to wait till you've got vegetables. But we've got people starving. Let's make two plates of food. Craig's about had it, looks like. Can't believe it. Yesterday he was with us and now. Okay, let Joe go ahead and eat. And we'll get Craig to eat because he's starving. Adam's starving too though, so. We're just gonna eat up, I guess. I don't know. Let's just get our guys down to where they're hungry. It's taking a lot of wood to make all this fuel, too. Man, making just one plate of food just is not worth it at all. It's like last resort kind of stuff. Alright, Craig needs to eat. We'll just get them down to where they're very hungry. They killed Dallas like a dog. Alright, everybody's just hungry and very hungry now, but Joe's tired and Craig is tired. Trying to clear my throat here, guys. I got something going on. Excuse me. But I wasn't going to let that guy take advantage of that woman. I'd done what I would have done in any other situation. I had a crowbar snuck up behind him. I would have used it. Didn't turn out too well, though. What else we got to do here? Let's go see if we can build and stuff. Can't build anything. We're out of components. We're just going to... It looks like we're going to skip... Can't make a saw blade, nothing. Let's go ahead and skip and let's put Adam in the bed though, just so he won't be tired at all. Don't want him standing around the whole day. Tempting, but there's no time to lounge. Okay, just gotta skip. Okay. So out of our three choices, who would we want to do the scavenging now? Nobody's tired, so Joe's depressed, Craig's sad, and Adam's sad. But Joe's the only one that's hungry. The other two are very hungry. Let's let Joe do the scavenging. Craig can guard. And we need someone up tomorrow, so we'll let Adam sleep it out. You don't want to go back to the supermarket, that's for sure. Oh, we needed to make a crowbar. I don't think we had what it took to make it, though. What about this garage? Before the war, you could have your car repaired there. Decent. If they still live there, they might be willing to trade with us. And maybe some food. I don't think... What do we have to trade? I don't even remember now. I don't think we're in a position to do any trading. Looted gas station. This is a very close place. This station is in a surprisingly decent shape. It may have been looted, but it might still be worth checking out. Let's do it. Yeah, we didn't have anything to do any trading with other than bandages. And bandages are very valuable. Maybe trading would be the right way to go there. Let's go ahead and scavenge here, though, see if we can find. It's up to you, Joe. Looks like people have drained it dry since it didn't blow up after the shelling. Go ahead and take that stuff. Be careful though, we don't know who's here. Let's take what we can find. Joe's got his head hanging there a little bit. I don't know what that's all about. Maybe from the depression? We don't want fertilizer or tobacco. We'll just take this stuff down here. We gotta move this rubble to get in. Excuse me. Slowly but surely. I had planned to make a shovel, but man, we don't have the materials right now. We didn't have them before either. We got raided that one night. We lost Dallas. Not going too well right now. We're gonna try and recover from it though. Come on. Oh. Doesn't look like there's any movement in this place. I see bars down there. That's a bad sign. We're not going to be able to get in there. Let's see what we got here. Look like a gas station slash like little convenience store. So there may be some food here. That'd be great. We're going ahead and get a move on. It doesn't look like there's anybody. Oh, there's some movement now. There's lots of water. Nice. We may have somebody here. Let's take a look. Okay, just a rat. Bandages and herbal meds. Nice. What's this? Okay, ingredients to make meds. We'll take those back. Craig may be able to use them. Let's leave this piece of wood and take these medical ingredients. Got lots of components. We need wood as well, though. Let's put the sugar down. And I don't remember what we need electrical parts for. We'll take them, though. What is this? What was that loud noise? There's a note under the table. Hit some jewelry inside the books. Look for them in the basement inside of carton boxes. Behind the barred door. Okay, there's where we're in trouble. Lots of banging going on. There may be actual people here somewhere. Looks like we got a basement. Put the electric parts back. Take some wood. There's just another exit out here. Upstairs, see if we can climb. This poor man had been caught by the shelling. What was he doing here? He's probably doing what I'm doing. I don't want to go downstairs. Stuff on the roof too. More wood. We need this wood. Let's put something back. Let's put the medical ingredients back. And did we need these parts? I don't remember. Did we need weapon parts? Yeah, we do need weapon parts, I think. We need these parts as well. Probably we need a new crowbar. We need saw blades. See what's over here. Lots more components in the wood. I already checked this one. We better look first. Looks clear. Breaking in here now? What's going on? Hearing all this banging. Yep. Might be something good here. Just more wood and parts. Alright. Let's go with what we got. Well, we didn't look in the basement, did we? I didn't even see where to get in the basement. Oh, there's a ladder. Okay. Let's see what we got down here. Ah, here we go. We don't want to pass any of this up. What are we going to put back? I'm thinking we don't need the weapon parts or the parts, to be quite honest, just yet. We've got some meat back at home. Man. Decisions. I think we've got a lot of wood. Let's put the wood back. Take the foods. There's some moonshine too. Oh no, that's not moonshine. That's pure alcohol. A small flask of pure alcohol. You can drink it, you can trade it, or you can use it to produce meds and bandages. Interesting. We'll have to remember that to there. We can't get in there. Alright, let's head back home. Hopefully we didn't get raided again. We really don't need that at this point. We gotta do something about stopping those raiders soon. We need some more defense. Ah, we did get raided. They took more food and some wood, man. We're having some bad luck. We've been raided twice. We lost a survivor. Got people hungry and depressed and tired. But we can fix the hungry right now. So we need 4 fuels. God, it takes a lot of components. Wow. I'd rather use 4 wood. Let's get everybody up here and get ready to eat. Everybody's gonna have a full belly, I believe, by the time we're done. Craig is hungry, really very hungry, slightly wounded, sad and tired. Let's go ahead and take care of his wounded, the wounded side. Can we use the meds? I feel fine, let's save the meds for later. Okay, let's bandage him up then. Go ahead and make us some grub, Joe. Now Craig is bandaged. We'll put him in the bed after this. That should make him be recovering. Well, everybody's got updates on their bios. Let's see what's going on here. Okay. Let's start at day 1. Well, day 4. Are there any animals left in the city? I'm so hungry. I'd even eat a rat or a pigeon. Okay, he liked it. We helped their mother. I don't want to get killed like Dallas. Maybe I could stay in the shelter while someone else goes out to search for supplies. Okay, so Adam wouldn't be too big on going out. We've got any food left? I'm starving. Okay, let's check out. Okay. Without food, we'll die. Dallas didn't make it back alive. I will miss his company. Aw. We won't survive if we can't get food. Defending our shelter against looters is crucial. We need to make sure we have enough weapons and keep watch at night. Dallas was killed last night. I'm glad it wasn't me. I gotta be careful. Selfish much? I must get some food. There goes the alarm for my nephew. Well, guys, we're gonna go ahead and end the stream here, I guess. We're on a string of bad luck here, but that's how it goes sometimes. We'll catch y'all back here. Leave some comments, subscribe, leave a like. Let me know if you want to keep this series going, and we'll see you next time here. Thanks for watching. It's been Budo Gaming here, guys.